This year's Hope for the Warriors golf tournament was out of this world, but not overshadowed by the eclipse.
Look at how dark you guys are. It's amazing.
Yes, this is a golf tournament. We are at River Landing in Wallace, North Carolina, raising money for our servicemen and women wounded in battle, some dealing with long-term problems. Many of the Warriors played, including our teammates, recovering Warriors Corey and Justin, who also got the chance to use an RPG-like device on one hole as our team drive, which was safe and a ton of fun and a perfect idea for this event. But it is not just the golf or the eclipse that brings a number of star celebs back each year, like my good friends, Hall of Fame catcher Johnny Bench and his Reds teammate, Doug Flynn.
There are stars in the sun.
We also have a contingent of musicians, with everyone getting involved at nighttime events, or even when we're with the troops. Here, Dylan Dixon, Rick Saray, and Teresa Wade wow them at Camp Lejeune.
So tell me about the podcast. It's called Hope for the Warriors
Talk Show.
And we get to see the talent from within Hope for the Warriors. Patty Catter is a Marine wife whose husband was wounded and in the Hope for the Warrior program.
You can look at my husband, and like I said, he does look good, especially with his shirt on. When he takes the shirt off, you see his scars from surgery on his back, and he had a neck surgery, and he does have invisible wounds of war, which traumatic brain injury. Mm-hmm. So when you just take time to explain to the community different things that the service members are going through, then they're gonna be able to help better and just be friendly to one another. And everybody has something, but especially our veterans. You know.
And this isn't something that's going away. It's
right.
Not like, okay, we've stopped the war in Iraq and stopped the war in Afghanistan, even though it looks like there's probably gonna be more troops over there. Yeah. This is ongoing for these guys.
Right, and my husband was injured in 2007, but he just had a back surgery just a few years, like 3 years ago. So it's something that he's going to be facing the rest of his life. It's never going to fully go away, his injuries. And that's just like a lot of our service members. They're going to need lifelong, I would say assistance in a way. But understanding is key.
And to help get the word out, Patty does a talk show podcast, soon to be an online TV show.
Actually, we're going to be launching it on Facebook Live.
Nice.
It's a Be Live TV stream that we're doing. Uh-huh. And the videos will be also available on YouTube and podcast on our website.
Okay. And what's the Facebook page that they would take a look at?
Hope for the Warriors.
Hope for the Warriors, which is a great page, which I go on a lot.
We also spend a day at Camp Lejeune seeing the facilities that help these guys and gals get back on their feet medically and emotionally. On this day, we hit the training center where the Marines put Navy medics through a rigorous battlefield medical course that has lifelike mannequins that allow them to simulate the catastrophic wounds of war. The save rate for battlefield wounds is well over 90% now compared to Vietnam, which was just in the 60% range. And many of the wounded who protect us need our help. But that's easy once you meet these young men and women who protect our country, as Doug Flynn, as always, says it best.
Your availability is much more important than your ability. When you can come put a face with what you're seeing on TV and talk about the structure of the war and what's going on and who are the kids and that are out there protecting our country, it's everything. It's changed my life. It's changed me about the way I think about things, about the way I go about my business, about the stuff that comes out of my mouth when I talk about this country. Hopefully it's helped me not to gripe and moan as much as I do because I'm upset about somebody who cut me off in traffic. When I come down here and see people that are laying it on the line to make it possible for me to be a baseball player or a banker or a husband, it's changed everything that I think about. And if you haven't been involved, look up hopeforthewarriors.org. Your money is well worth it. 90% of it is going to these men and women who serve and protect our country. Truthfully, Johnny, it's the best thing I do.
Hope for the Warriors is a nonprofit that has high ratings. Here's the website. You can sign up for the 2018 event. Not only is it a ton of fun, but inspiring as an American. Join us.